So there's been some comments on some other Computerphile videos asking what an Arduino is. So we're going to cover what makes different Arduinos, how you can get involved in them, why they're so good, show some little examples, and talk about some other alternatives to the mainstream Arduinos. Here I have a Duomalove from 2009. This is my first Arduino. That actually came in a kit, so it gives you a kit with all the components and things. So basically what an Arduino is, it's an open source electronics platform. So it allows people who aren't necessarily very knowledgeable in electronics, like myself, to really easily get involved and make cool things. So as a quick example of that, here we have a breadboard, basically a solderless circuit. So it allows you to just plug things into these slots without having to solder anything. So it's really easy and clean to get involved with electronics. The Arduino has a set of pins. So we've got a row of analog and power pins and a row of digital pins. We've got a couple of wires here just to plug into the Arduino. And then this is a piezo element, so this will play sound. And that's pretty much it. On the digital pins, the Arduino will output digital signals to control electronics, and on the power and the analog pins, output analog signals or output power, obviously. We're going to plug the red cable into the 5-volt and the black cable into the ground. So these just provide the power, so they're just completing the electrical circuit. Here you've got the power pins and some analog pins, and over here you've got your digital pins. This blue one is our data pin, and this goes in the digital slot 9. That is 9, isn't it? Yeah. So that goes in 9. Okay, so that's now everything plugged in. So we've got the speaker is taking data from pin 9 on the Arduino, because the program we've written just happens to send data of port 9. So then looking at the board, we have this red rail, which is our 5-volt rail, and the blue one, which is our ground rail, so that's where the power's coming from. We then have this blue cable coming from the speaker into the data, and we have the ground cable going to the speaker to complete the circuit. Here we have the Arduino IDE. So Arduino is programmed with a variation on C. A basic Arduino program has a setup and a loop, and then there's a lot of different functions available to access the things on the board. For example, here you've got digital write, so that writes something to a digital pin. For all intents and purposes, it is C. We're going to plug the IDE into the Arduino. So on this one, it's a rather crusty and old USB-B. But newer ones use micro USB. That's my code. So this will set up the speaker to play. So I'm going to compile it first, make sure there's no errors. So Arduino programs are typically called sketches. It kind of gets across the idea that Arduino is made for hobbyists and artists, not so much programmers. So that's now compiled, as you can see from here. So it's done compiling, and we've got a nice little output that tells us what was compiled and how many bytes were used, etc. Okay, now I'm going to upload it. So this will now push it to the Arduino. So it's compiling the sketch again. So you can see some lights are flashing on here now as it uploads.
Do you know any other tunes?
Not at all. I'm very unmusically sound. So on this file, we've got an array of beats, and we've got an array of notes. With each note, we have a tone, and the tone is output to the digital pin and then sent to the speaker. You can see here, pin mode, speaker pin, output. So the pin that that's plugged into is in output mode, and we've named it speaker pin. And in the loop, we just play back the list up there. So we're delaying it by the beats to set the tempo, and then we're playing notes. If we're not currently playing a note, then we delay. If we are playing a note, then we play the note that we're currently on. Arduino has come quite a way since it started in 2005. When it first started, they didn't realise how big the uptake would be in terms of people customising and accessories. So this pin layout has kind of become a fixed form factor. So if we look at this one, so this is the new Arduino Yun from 2013-odd. So it's got the exact same pin layout, and it's more or less the exact same size. So people have made things called shields, which are basically accessories that provide other functionality, and they plug into the pins on top. So you have Arduino compatible boards, which are similar boards or similar functionality that works to this pin layout. The whole platform's open source. There's many clones that use the same pin layout. There's many accessories and shields that use the same pin layout. So it's kind of, they've kind of inadvertently made the next hardware standard. There's multiple forms of Arduino compatible. So, I mean, if you look at these two, so these are completely compatible. So they've got the same layout, so they're compatible with Arduino shields. So shields have to correspond to this layout. But then you can have things that are Arduino compatible in that they use the same software and use the same development environments. This is DIY Arduino called a shrimping it. It's made out of a shrimp kit. This does roughly have the same pin layout, but it's not in the same shape. So you couldn't plug a shield into this without modification. But this can be programmed by the Arduino IDE and uses the Arduino software. So this is still Arduino compatible. This is actually based on one of the more popular Arduinos at the moment, the Uno. And does all the same stuff. It's just much, much cheaper. So, I mean, one of these with all the components and stuff costs about £60. One of these with all the components These are costing us about £20 a kit.
£60, which is probably what, $100, something like that. Yeah. Are people ripping them off then?
Kind of. There is a big issue with, so these ones, they don't mind. They encourage this sort of thing where someone makes a clone, a cheaper clone, and makes it open source and provides the parts, etc. They don't mind that. The big problem they have is Chinese companies making Arduino clones, calling them Arduinos, and then selling them for $9. That's the big issue they currently have, because they don't have the mark of quality these ones do. I mean, if you look at the Duomo, they're very fond of their circuit board arts. You get a nice little picture of Italy there, and this whole blue PCB thing was kind of a trend kind of started by them. Rather than putting the green circuit board covering on, they left it blue, and they've kind of started a trend for blue PCBs. The only Arduino boards that are allowed to be called Arduinos are those made by the Arduino Foundation themselves.
Surely if it's open source, okay, how can they control it?
It's not people ripping off and cloning it that are concerned with, it's the Arduino name, so it's more of a trademark issue than a technical issue or an intellectual property issue. They just don't like people. They want people, if you buy a board with Arduino written on it, if you buy a board from Arduino, they want you to know that it's quality and it's made in Italy and it's got this whole homebrew feel about it. Whereas you don't want to be buying a cheap knockoff for $9 that's going to break in about a month, like our one frequently does, and have that called an Arduino. So to an even more extreme degree, you have the Makey Makey. So we use one of these in the texting with a recorder video. Basically what these are they are a really easy way for kids to get involved in electronics. They allow you to plug things in and make controllers. So they work on an electric potential. So for example, you can plug fruit in and touch the fruit and it will trigger a key press. So they're using the same microprocessor that the Arduinos are. The pin layout's completely different and they don't really act like an Arduino does, but they are based in the Arduino software. And you can unlock the full Arduino within it and get more control of it. So these are not necessarily Arduino compatible, but based upon Arduino. So this is a Raspberry Pi. So this is covered in the earlier video. And this has kind of taken the hobbyist electronic world by storm. And as a result, a lot of people have heard of Raspberry Pi, but not necessarily Arduino, even though Arduino's been around a lot longer. So the key differences between this is a full computer. This can run Linux as opposed to the small microcontroller of an Arduino. And while this does have pins that you can use for digital input and output and various other standards I2C and that sort of thing, it doesn't have the full range of digital and analog capabilities that the Arduino does. So it's not as good for hobbyist hardware. And because it is a full-blown computer and has a full Linux operating system, it's not as easy to mess around with stuff. So if you wanted to flash an LED with a Raspberry Pi, you'd have to install an operating system on it, enable the output pins, write a program for it, whereas with an Arduino, plug it in, upload a program, plug an LED into a slot, and you're good to go. So Arduinos and Raspberry Pis use quite a lot in Internet of Things hacks, like sensors around your house or common everyday items, and combine them together to do different functions. So the Arduino is really good because it's really well powerful sensors, but it doesn't really have any internet connectivity. So how we've done this previously is we attach an Arduino to a Raspberry Pi, and then we give a Raspberry Pi wireless adapter. And then we collect data from the internet with a Raspberry Pi and feed it to the Arduino, which was a lot of components and it had a lot of points for failure. But with the new Arduinos, so the Arduino Yun being one of them, this is kind of a hybrid between the Pi and the Arduino Uno, or the Duomalov in this case. So what you have here is a Linux system on a chip and the 80 mega microcontroller. So you've got an Arduino chip and a Linux system on one chip, and this also has Wi-Fi. So this is a really neat setup. You don't need to worry about having two boards, and you don't have to worry about Wi-Fi adapters. I mean, the Wi-Fi configuration on the Raspberry Pi is a complete pain. It's been the death of more than one hack. Whereas with this, plug it in, it makes a Wi-Fi network, you connect to the Wi-Fi network, it then goes to a nice configuration page, you tell it which network to connect to, and then it's just done. It's on the internet, you've got a full Linux computer running on the internet, which also has an Arduino on it, and you can program this over Wi-Fi, so you don't have to use any cables. So it's really good for hobbyists and people doing stuff at home, but it also has very serious usages. So for example, there's a project called the ArduSat now, which is making tiny satellites out of Arduinos, and they're CubeSats, so basically they're to a certain standard, so they're tiny little cube satellites, and they are fully run by Arduinos. So people are launching these into space to do very serious applications. So it's gone from being a fun little hobbyist platform for interactive artists and people making remote control cars and solar panels and button games to actually being used in hobbyist space programs. The standard Arduino experimentation kit come with a light sensor and a motor. So it's really easy to rig up things, for example, like a solar panel that tracks the sun. If you've got a light sensor, you can then program it to keep track of the light and follow the light, and then the motor would just turn whatever assembly you've got to hold your solar panel.